Who might that be?
We've sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door.
We have no bread. I don't want your bread.
Then what is it you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in that belly now, is there? And there will never be. Unless you do exactly as I say. In 3 days' time, a blue moon will appear. Only then can the curse be undone.
What curse?
The one I placed on this house.
What are you talking about?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a lovely couple, but not lovely neighbors. You see, your mother was with child, and she developed an unusual appetite. She admired my beautiful garden, and she told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fiddle ferns, and lettuce. He said, all right, but it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, rooting through my rutabaga, raiding my arugula, and ripping up the rampion, my champion, my favorite. I should have laid a spell on him right there. I could have turned him into stone, or a dog, or a chair. I let him have the rampion, I'd lots to spare. In return, however, I said, fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And call it square.
I had a brother?
No. But you had a sister.
Where is she?
She's mine now. And you'll never find her. Small price to pay for what else your father stole from me. It cost me my youth, my beauty. My mother warned me. She would punish me with the curse of ugliness if I ever lost any of them.
Lost what?
The beans.
Beans?
Special beans. I let him go. I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall when bang, crash, a lightning flash. Story. Never mind. Anyway, at last the big day came. I made my claim. Oh, don't take away the baby, they shrieked and screeched. But I did, and I hid her where she'll never be reached. Your father cried, and your mother died, went for extra measure. I admit it was a pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not mollified. And I laid a little spell on them. You too, son. That your family tree would always be a barren one.
How could you do that?
And when your mother died, your father deserted you. Your father was no father, so why should you be? Now there's no more fuss and there's no more scenes, and my garden thrives. You should see my nectarines, but I'm telling you the same I tell kings and queens. Don't ever, never, ever mess around with my greens.